Hi, I'm Pantazis Deligiannis. I'm a senior research engineer at Microsoft Research, where I have been working for the last 4 years. Before joining Microsoft, I did my PhD at Imperial College London, where I was researching new techniques for automatically finding concurrency bugs in distributed systems. At Microsoft Research, I'm part of a team that is designing and applying such automated testing techniques on cloud services developed in Azure to make them more reliable. So together with my MSR colleagues, we created Coyote, which is the .NET library and tool for writing concurrency unit tests in C#. Coyote provides APIs for writing these tests, as well as program specifications and declaring sources of nondeterminism in your program. The tool focuses on task-based concurrency and is able to take control of the task execution during testing. Coyote also provides advanced APIs for writing and testing asynchronous actors and state machines. In the core of Coyote is a scheduler that enumerates interleavings between tasks and is able to replay any bug that is found by the tool. And the secret sauce behind this technology is efficient program search algorithms that are able to find most bugs. We should say here that Coyote is not doing verification. Instead, the program search is a best effort in finding bugs under a given bound. But what we have found in practice is that this works really well. Coyote is the result of years of research engineering and deep engagements with internal product teams. It is being used so far by more than 15 critical production services inside Azure. This includes services that manage hundreds of thousands of customer VMs, so it's really important that they operate reliably and have no bugs. We released Coyote as open source last year in March and hope that everyone writing such systems can learn about Coyote and take advantage of it. Let me give you a motivation of the problem. Concurrency is a fundamental paradigm of computer science, and many software systems critical to the success of companies like Microsoft are highly concurrent. These systems include microservices such as the one that you can see here. This example here is a typical service developed on Azure. It was designed with an ASP.NET microservice architecture that allows it to scale horizontally on a Kubernetes cluster. The service can receive tens of thousands of client requests at the same time and must carefully synchronize data accesses in backend storage systems. So how can we use Coyote to test the correctness of the system and ensure that we find all critical bugs? This kind of bugs that we really do not want to manifest in production, because they could lead to serious issues such as service downtime or loss of customer data. And who really wants this to happen in their service? Today, developers rely on techniques such as stress testing to weed out concurrency bugs. However, these techniques are often ineffective, with bugs escaping into production and only manifesting in live sites, making them very painful to debug. But why is that? Why concurrency testing is so much harder than sequential testing? So testing concurrent code should not be so hard, and we believe that every developer, to be productive, should be able to write unit tests for concurrency code as simply as writing regular unit tests. Welcome to Project Coyote. We have been working on technology to enable exactly this capability. Let's first look at a very simple example. Here you can see a sequential dictionary with a simple set of APIs. You can add a key and its value, you can check if a key exists, and you can remove a key. Now, the dictionary is not thread safe, so threads are expected to take a lock before they try to access the dictionary to avoid race conditions. Now, since the internal implementation of the dictionary is sequential, someone could test it by writing a simple test like the one that you can see here on the code. For example, we could try to add a few keys with their values, we can then remove a key, and then we can assert that the key was indeed removed. Okay, this was easy. But what do we do for a concurrent dictionary is the one that you can see here, which by design can allow a large number of threads to access it at the same time without holding a lock. The underlying implementation of the dictionary must make sure that in the presence of concurrent accesses, the dictionary will still work as expected. And for example, it will not end up losing values or keys due to race conditions. Now, how do we test this? If we try to write a sequential test, like in the previous example, like the one that you can see here on the code, it will not be really enough to cover corner cases where the dictionary is accessed in parallel. What if we try to write a concurrent test like this one, which spawns a bunch of tasks that access the dictionary at the same time? This seems like a better idea, right? So the problem is that it is not guaranteed that the tasks will execute in the right order that would cause a bug to manifest. And let's say that we try to write a stress test that tries to spawn like tons and tons of tasks to stress test the dictionary. We might actually find a bug, But how do we replay the same exact task order that led to the bug, since we don't really control the execution of these tasks? And this is where Coyote helps. Coyote controls all these tasks and other sources of concurrency in your program, and is able to explore the many possible execution paths to discover concurrency bugs. Okay, let's see how you can use Coyote to test the system that we saw earlier. So Coyote allows you to write what we call a concurrency unit test. This test looks very similar to the one that we saw earlier for the concurrent dictionary. So what is happening here in the code is that we can first initialize the state of the test, which includes mocks of external components, as well as components of the service that we want to test. Next, we spawn a bunch of concurrently executing tasks, each one performing some request on the actual service. Finally, we can wait for these tasks to terminate, and then assert that the state of the mock is consistent, which in our case means that no data were lost or corrupted by the service because of a bug. Now, the cool thing is that Coyote is able to control all the executing tasks and explore interleavings and corner cases to find bugs. Let's see now how Coyote works under the hood. Now that we have written a concurrency unit test, we can first compile our production code, mocks and tests, into a binary. Next, Coyote loads the binary and rewrites it by inserting hooks and stubs that allow Coyote to take control of the C# tasks in your program. Now that the binary is instrumented, we can run the concurrency unit test as if it was any other regular unit test. To find bugs, Coyote quickly executes each test from beginning to the end, thousands of times, each time exploring a different execution path and task interleavings. To achieve this, Coyote takes control of the tasks in your program, serializes the program execution, and executes a single task at a time. And this is where the magic happens. While Coyote executes the serialized program, it keeps track of all possible scheduling decisions in each step of the execution. You can think of a step as a point during a program's execution when some concurrent action is taken. For example, a new task is created, or a task acquires a lock, or waits for another task to complete. Now, each time Coyote executes a concurrency unit test, it is able to explore different orders of such scheduling decisions. And this exploration is what allows Coyote to expose concurrency bugs deep inside your program's execution paths. Now, the cool thing is that once Coyote finds a bug, it provides a trace that allows this bug to be fully reproduced every single time. And using this trace, you can start the Visual Studio Debugger and happily debug the issue. Let me show you now how you can use Coyote in practice. You can easily install it from command line by running .NET tool install using the Coyote package from Nugget. Waiting a few seconds and you see, oh, the latest version of Coyote has now been successfully installed. So there it is, you are ready to go. So now you can see if you run Coyote on your command line, you can see that the tool is running and you can get all the various options that you can use to run the tool and, you know, run the test in your program. So let's try Coyote on a simple example. What you can see here is a thread-safe bounded buffer that allows multiple tasks to access the buffer and put or get objects without holding any locks. The cool thing is that this program contains a deadlock, and I will show you in a bit how Coyote can help us catch this bug. I will not dive into details here, but you can read about this program and the backend contains in our blog post. So if I run the unmodified program, you can see that we can quickly trigger the deadlock. The program actually gets stuck, right? Let's now try to run Coyote on it. First, we need to run Coyote in rewriting mode, which rewrites the DLL for testing, and this allows Coyote to inject logic that takes control of the tasks and concurrency APIs. And now that we have rewritten the program, what we can do is we can now run Coyote in test mode, let's say for 100 iterations, and see if it can catch the bug. You can see that it actually finds the bug, right? And now what we can do is we can use a special mode of Coyote called replay that allows us to replay any bug that Coyote has previously found. And Coyote is able to do that because it produces a special file that we call schedule that contains all the scheduling choices that Coyote did in order to find the bug in the program that we just ran. So running this, as you can see, it allows us to fully reproduce the bug. And now you can run this special command called break to attach the piece of code to the debugger and happily debug the issue. Feel free to check out the GitHub repository of Project Coyote. The code is open source, it's available for everyone, and we would love to receive your contributions. You can also find our Coyote package in its Nugget page. You can easily download it in your Visual Studio project and play with it and test your projects with this. Please feel free to check out our website of Coyote, which has core concepts, examples, case studies. You can try things on your own. You can read the documentation of the various programming models that Coyote supports. Check out the APIs. And importantly, it contains various tutorials that you can follow in order to learn how to use Coyote in practice and apply it on your source code. If you want, you can check out also our list of publications. Over the last few years, we have published in some of the top conferences in the area of concurrency in programming languages, doing cutting-edge research in finding concurrency bugs in distributed systems. Please check out our blog post on how Coyote was used to find this tricky deadlock in the bounded buffer example that we showed you earlier. We would love to see your contributions. Please try it out on your projects, and we would love to hear of any hard concurrency bugs that Coyote helped you find in your code. Please feel free to send us your feedback. Thank you for watching this video.